And we turn to Syria, where rebels have taken control of several key border crossings in the bloodiest 24 hours of fighting since the uprising began 16 months ago. The regime's intelligence chief, injured in a bomb attack on Wednesday, died today. He was the fourth figure in President Assad's inner circle to be killed in that blast. And as the crisis deepened, thousands are fleeing across the border. Lindsey Hilsum of Independent Television News reports.
He was the highest-ranking Christian in President Bashar al-Assad's government. The funeral of Defense Minister Dawood Rajia was held at the Greek Orthodox Church of the Holy Cross in Damascus this morning. The congregation cheered the Syrian army, whom they see as their protectors, even as they mourned the minister and three other security officials killed apparently by a bomb on Wednesday. As the coffin was taken away for burial, they cheered President Assad. A mile or so to the south, the suburb of Midan bears the scars of several days of fighting. The rebel Free Syrian Army seized control earlier in the week, but today government forces took it back. The rebels can mount hit-and-run attacks, but they still can't hold on to territory in the capital if the government counters with artillery and heavy weapons. A few people tentatively return to their homes. Tens of thousands of others, though, are driving to the border with Lebanon. They fear that this is just the beginning of the battle for Damascus.
People were crossing into Lebanon until the early hours. But many of those I've been speaking to today say there's nothing going on in Damascus. They're supporters of President Bashar al-Assad. They don't want to say that there's any threat to his regime, but they're getting their families out nonetheless. Are you telling me that there is no fighting in Damascus?
No. It's okay. Relax. Nothing.
Everybody in Damascus is relaxed, are they?
Yes.
But maybe he had a reason for his reticence. We spotted someone lurking and listening. Fear doesn't stop at the border. Journalists leaving Damascus say Wednesday's killing of defense officials was a turning point.
The bomb attack changed a lot. That made the situation very, very, very tense, meaning that people really did not go out at all unless they had to.
We met a group of Syrians already in Lebanon who've been buying mattresses for refugees who'll be accommodated in schools. They were expecting 3,000 to arrive on buses in the coming hours.
I think Damascus is prepared now for a big battle. So Damascus is going to be out of civilian for sure. I mean, going to be empty of civilian. So we should prepare ourselves for that situation. I think Damascus is going to be the last battle.
In the Syrian capital, on this, the first Friday of Ramadan, opposition supporters demonstrated after midday prayers. In some neighborhoods, they were met with bullets. Government forces and the feared pro-Assad militia, the Shabiha, in action. This afternoon, funeral processions surged down the streets. Dozens were killed. Fighters and activists regarded as martyrs by the rebels. They're mourning their dead, as government supporters mourn theirs. And the killing isn't over yet.
In New York today, the United Nations Security Council voted to renew the 300-member observer force in Syria for another 30 days. Their mandate was set to expire today. And a Virginia court sentenced a man who spied on Syrian dissidents in the U.S. to 18 months in prison. Mohammed Suwaid admitted he sent audio and video recordings to members of Syria's intelligence agency. He also met with President Assad in Syria to discuss dissident activity in the U.S. Suwaid was arrested and charged last year. Find the story we reported about Suwaid in December on our website.